Trinitite is interesting because it's a relatively small-scale nuclear detonation. Byproducts of the detonation was the formation of a glass known now as Trinitite. It's a green glass, and it occurred about 370 meters in every direction. The evaporation behavior that we see in the Trinity test site almost exactly mimics what we see in lunar samples that were formed about 4 to 4.5 billion years ago. My name is James Day, and I'm an associate professor at Scripps, and I study the formation of planets and the geochemistry of volcanic rocks. What I did was I took some of this glass and I crushed it up, powdered it, and I subjected this glass to different acids. And then what I did was I took all of this together and I measured them using a mass spectrometer. And so we measured the relative ratio of the heavy and the light isotopes to tell us about evaporation in these glasses. If this is the site of the detonation, where my finger is, and this is the furthest point from the detonation, we see a progressive increase in volatile abundances as we move away from the detonation. If we extrapolate that now to our understanding of how planets form, we now have a clearer indication of what the processes were that were leading to the loss of volatile compounds like water. Why, for example, the moon is dry and the earth is wet. And so in this way, we can use a human-made experiment that had severe consequences for human history to scientific benefit.